ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وحبيبه، قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل دينه حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا وعن الإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جازيت به نبيا عن قومه ورسولا عن أمته. اللهم أحينا على سنته وأمتنا على ملته، واحشرنا تحت لوائه وأوردنا حوضه، واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. أما بعد، ففي حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: لتأمرن بالمعروف ولتنهون عن المنكر أو ليبعثن الله عليكم عذابا. Either you enjoin the good and forbid the evil, or else Allah will send a punishment unto you. Definitely nobody could be certain about the intention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we should be sure about his sunnah. We should be sure that the sunnah of Allah is giving us a choice. Either we enjoin the good and forbid the evil, or else Allah would send punishment upon us. And what we are going through these days is a true punishment, a true test and a true trial of our resolve as believers to go back to the norm, enjoining the good and forbidding the evil. Humans have the capacity of doing good and they have the capacity to do evil. Allah is always encouraging us to do what is best for us. Our best interest is to follow his guidance. Our best interest is to cleanse our societies, to cleanse our hearts, to cleanse and purify our intentions, and to make sure that we are standing for what is right and we are doing what is best for not only us but for the entire humanity. So enjoining the good and forbidding the evil has been remarked by some scholars as the sixth pillar of Islam. We know Islam has five pillars. Those scholars are profoundly saying and believing that without this pillar, Islam will mean nothing. So if Islam is only about praying and only about fasting and only about Hajj and Umrah and Zakah, then Islam is very, very personal. But Islam is not a personal religion. Islam is not a personal belief system that you keep in your mind with some rituals whenever you can. Islam is a faith that's intended to change the direction of the world and to guide humanity as a whole, to believe in God, to follow his guidance, and to submit to his will. Without that, without enjoining the good, without forbidding the evil, there is no submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. Nay, by your Lord, they would not be counted as believers until they take your judgment in matters they have disputed. So taking the judgment of Allah sounds to be a very good pillar of Islam, that you follow his guidance, that you love his book, that you follow his prophet, that you correct what's wrong in your personal life, in your personal belief, in your habits, in your customs. Anything that harms you or harms anyone is very much against Islam itself. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam summarizes this concept for us saying, لا ضرر ولا ضرار. Do not harm yourself and do not harm others. And that's why it is very important for us as a community not only to enjoin the good, not only to forbid the evil, not only to do justice and do what is right, but to also invite others to do it. This is enjoining what's good. Enjoining means calling others to Allah, to submit to Him, to believe in Him, to appreciate Him, and to appreciate His gifts. This is what Islam is really about. If Islam were a personal religion, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam wouldn't have faced his entire society and community who stood all against him except for very few. For 3 years, he only was able to earn the acceptance of Islam by 63 people. Mind you, 3 years, 36 months, and he only got 2 people a month almost, 63. That's a number. So if Islam was private, then Quraysh would not have objected to him. The idol worshippers would not have objected to him. They actually asked him, mind your business and we mind our business. Worship your God the way you want and we worship the idols the way we want. He said no. Then they said, okay, you worship our God one day, we worship your God one day. He said no. Why? Because believing in Allah is not an idea. It is not a voluntary act of acquiescing a prophet because we're afraid of him. It is the right of Allah on us who created us to believe in him and to submit to him. And as we mentioned, since the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam laid the rule, let there be no harm upon yourself and let there be no harm upon others. Inshallah, we'll do the prayer in 1 minute. And the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is for everybody first to direct yourself to the Qibla. And since the line of the cars as it stands in front of me is going a little bit left from where the Qibla is, I would like to invite everybody, number one, pray in your car. Do not leave your car. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told the companions when it was raining, he said, "Sallu fi rihalikum." Pray on your own back of your own ride. Whether it's a donkey, a horse, a camel, pray where you are. And since it is very cold, we would like for everybody to direct themselves to the Qibla as to turn right about 10 degrees or so. Turn right in your seat, in your car. And if you could accommodate other people who did not bring their cars, please do so. Light your car for people to come and join you. So everybody could join. Don't move your car, brother. Please. Don't move your car. Leave your car as is, but just turn right 10 degrees in your seat, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala place His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept him and give him the intercession on behalf of his ummah. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وبعد اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت اللهم اكشف عنا البلاء والمحن وسائر الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وأقم الصلاة